ViPi has now lost for 3 years, and we have now come to the end of the project. On this DVD, you will find all the information about the project, our outcomes, as well as further information coming directly from the participants in the piloting of this project. Focus in ViPi was on the provision of basic ICT skills training of people with disabilities. We have created a curriculum, we have created supporting games, both for desktop usage as well as mobile usage on Android. And we have created an online portal where various learning objects relevant to the training of basic ICT skills training can be found, downloaded, and can be further shared with others in your community. We also have a mobile version of this application, again available for Android, and maybe something to emphasize, everything is available for free. The project started in 2011 and has now come to an end in December 2013. In the following videos, we are going to present on the one hand the project itself. We are going to focus in towards the various pilots, and then finally we'll give you the chance to also explore the various outcomes that we have created in this project. The ViPi project basically has as focus to help people with disabilities to get better understanding of ICT and start from the basic level. So we actually help people with disabilities to understand what is ICT, what is a computer build of, to understand what are the components of a computer. And next, actually to give them, to empower them when they, for example, want to look for a job, that they know, okay, there will be ICT skills that are required, but we want to actually give them the basic ICT skills so that when they come to an office, that it's not like, oh, a computer, I don't know how to use it. And that's what we want to do in the ViPi project. It's a project that is running for 3 years, started in 2011. And within the project, on the one hand, we're going to create a curriculum for basic ICT skills training. On the other hand, we're also going to create a mobile application that makes use of social networks, because we believe that if people think something is good, they want to share it with their friends. Within the project, we're also going to launch a platform. The platform itself will contain a complete repository of apps, applications, documents, reference to interesting websites, reference to games that help or that can help people to better grasp the basic ICT skills. In terms of social networking and the networking tools, we also have integrated the community in there. So within the community, we again want to help people to share their experience. On the one hand, we will have the end user beneficiary, people with disabilities. On the other hand, we will also have the trainers, because there might be trainers that say, hey, this is interesting what we have done in, for example, in Belgium, and this might be interesting, for example, what people would like to do in Greece. So we have kind of integrated everything: curriculum, platform where people can find the different learning objects, because that's what we call them. And then at the same time, we have provided an integrated social environment. The criteria that we have used to make the selections of all these kind of, outcomes, because that's what we want to do in the project, was, first of all, we wanted it to be free. We do not want, when we create something with taxpayers' money, that people in the end also have to pay for it. We believe this is not a good usage of funds. So we have created the platform using open source technology. The platform obviously will be fully free to be used. The applications that we are creating are based on the Android platform. Again, those applications will be provided for free. The social network environment, again, there we made use of an open source environment, will be again be provided for free. And there is also a learning environment where we can help trainers as well as beneficiaries to understand better the curriculum, but also be helped with the videos, with pictures, you name it. Again, we use open source software for that, again for free. So in the end, we will have a curriculum which will be created on a Creative Commons license agreement, which basically means we created a curriculum, but we don't claim that we are the best in the world. So, for example, you take over the curriculum and you say, I want to improve this, I want to extend this, you're free to do it. You can base yourself on what we have created and you can extend it. The only thing we ask is, please inform us back on what you have done so that we can integrate that again later on in an updated version and provide it again to the community.
I think if there's going to be a quality to the research, it's actually going to affect the importance for the young people or anybody with a disability. If they have been involved in the research, if they've made suggestions for changes, whether things work, whether they don't work, it makes the end product much, much better. And people are much more likely to use it because they think, I have had a part in this, this is something I can use.
Because I'm an expert from City Council as well as because I've represented a lot of people, what they were saying. I am expert talking from learning expertise. So I'm good at talking. There's a lot of conferences because £10 takes me long.
Actually, my research has been mainly focused on people with intellectual disabilities. However, being in special education schools and classroom all the time, I had the opportunity to play a lot, play physical and digital games. And the one thing that I can say is that no matter what kind of disability you might have, gaming and playing is all about abilities. My brother, he's 5 years younger than me and he has intellectual disability. So playing and gaming has been always for us the main medium of communication. And since he's the greatest teacher and the greatest mentor I've ever had, it is the main way to communicate with everybody.
ICT is ook voor mensen met een beperking een heel belangrijk hulpmiddel tegenwoordig. Het kan in zekere zin de beperktheden van hun handicap compenseren. ICT kan in vele gevallen mensen met een handicap helpen om een betere integratie te krijgen in de maatschappij.
Dat mensen met een beperking ook kunnen inclusie hebben, ook in, met de normale mensen kunnen overweg gaan. Want de maatschappij van de dag van tegenwoordig is een maatschappij die volledig gebaseerd is op computers en informatica. En ook die mensen moeten mee kunnen in deze maatschappij, dat ze niet achter blijven gaan. Dat ze niet ook terug in een verdomhoekje worden gebracht. En dat is dus het belang van deze sessies eigenlijk. Het beste dat ik ervan vond is de groepsfeer die er was, de heterogeniteit van de groep. We zaten met heel zwakke deelnemers en ook erg sterke deelnemers. En de sterkeren hielpen de zwakkeren. En ook de sterkeren hadden soms een probleem en de zwakkeren kon hen er ook bij helpen. Dus was er ook een vriendschap, nieuwe vriendschappen die ontstaan zijn. Het vertrouwen die de deelnemers hebben in hun mentoren is ook erg van belang. Ze nemen dus ook andere problemen die ze hebben, durven ze ook al een keer aankaarten. Maar altijd en meestal gebeurt het altijd met de ICT-vlak.
Aan dergelijke training vond ik het best en aangenaamst voor mij. Dat ik zag dat ze heel snel vooruit ging, maar vele van die mensen er eigenlijk niks tot heel weinig van kenden. Dat je heel snel evolutie zag en een enorme interesse. Liefde, dat is een haven. Dat is eigenlijk het voornaamste voor mij. Dat ik mij goed kan en al bijblijven.
Het zijn dus meerdere mensen die eigenlijk nog nooit met een computer gewerkt hebben. Die komen naar de lessen. Maar die dat wel op een eenvoudige manier uitgelegd krijgen om daarmee om te gaan. En dus we moeten in feite van A tot Z alles uitleggen. En we zien dat we in feite in de loop van de lessen resultaten kunnen behalen, waardoor dat die mensen ook stellen van dat ze toch bepaalde zaken nu al kunnen opzoeken, met Google werken en ook al zelfs mails versturen. Dat is zeer belangrijk voor hen en ook naar muziek toe. Als ze iets willen opzoeken van muziek, hebben ze ook al een stuk bijgeleerd. En in die zin zijn voor de mensen die lessen volgen zeer belangrijk dat zij een stuk meer zelfstandigheid verkrijgen daardoor. En een stuk ook kunnen integreren op het vlak van werken met PC.
Nou, het beste is eigenlijk dat je die interactie kunt zien met de mensen die effectief iets hebben bijgeleerd en dat je ziet hoe dat ze met geen dat ze bijgeleerd hebben dingen kunnen doen, met elkaar kunnen communiceren. En dat ze ook zelf naar je toe komen zeggen van merci dat ik dat heb kunnen leren. En ja, je ziet gewoon dat ze vooruit gaan. Je ziet ze hebben gewoon iets bijgeleerd en zijn er tevreden over. En ik ben dan ook tevreden.
Well, I think it comes back to the question of engagement. And I think if you're able to engage students, some people engage really well with games, some people engage well with word processing, all sorts of different types of, you know, both technology and software.
The Greek piloting phase of ViPi project took place in Athens with the participation of 20 trainees with severe mobility disabilities, mainly due to spinal cord injuries, multiple sclerosis, and muscular dystrophy. The Greek trainees were already highly experienced in internet and computer usage, so we chose to focus on more advanced level training courses, like the development of a website from scratch using an open source CMS like WordPress. Also, we went through some basic video editing and subtitling of YouTube videos, as well as collaborative video conferencing and desktop sharing over Skype and Google Hangouts.
Ik vond van de training zeer goed, want ik kost in mijn hen tamelijk niet werken met een computer. Ik heb nu al een e-mailadres kunnen aanmaken. En Facebook kunnen aanmaken en een paar nieuwe toetsen geleerd, zoals de openstart. Het leukste was van de allerlessen, het was er toffe bende die mee was, die mee doet in de les. Toffe sfeer en vooral die chatten op die mentoren we geleerd hebben. Vrij toffe leraars, omdat ze meer aandachtig zijn. Omdat ze meer luisteren en als je het ze niet vraagt, ze komen af. Als je het nog niet vraagt, ze blijven afkomen.
I think one of the problems is that people have heard, and there's much in the press about the dangers, particularly of the internet, I think, and that has perhaps clouded people's whole view. So if we don't allow them to use it, we'll keep them safe, rather than if we teach people to be safe, they can use this technology in through their lives. So I think that's the danger, that people are worried, how will I be seen? Will I lose my job? How will this organization be seen if something happens? Rather than, okay, this technology is there, it's to help people, and we've got to make sure people see the benefits and also are aware of what potential dangers are, and that's part of the training, rather than just saying absolutely blanket they can't use it at all.